So to create an implementation project, we have to go to setup and maintenance from the navigator. From here, we need to access. And to create an implementation project, we have to click on implementation projects. So before going to create an implementation project, I will explain you here a bit. So these are the different offerings that we have in Fusion. If you see here, like compensation management, customer data management, enterprise contracts, financials, Fusion Accounting Hub, grants management, incentive compensation, manufacturing and supply chain management, marketing, obsolete materials, whatever it is. Like that, there are so many offerings. So the last one is workforce deployment and workforce development. So if you see here, whenever I'm changing these offerings, the corresponding documents are getting changed here. You see, have you seen? So what does it mean? It means each and every offering, whatever you select, according to that, the corresponding content guides, associated features, task lists, business objects, and business applications, you will get all these documents here. So you can download it from here, and if you want for your reference purpose, you can just read it once. Okay, what are all the tasks mandatory? What are all the tasks not mandatory? For example, let's see. Let's click on this. Download a document. Because once you start the implementation project, you have some free time, 1 or 2 days initially, you won't have work. So that time what you can do is at least to reach out, to read, like, you know, all these are product features and what are all the tasks available and everything. Okay. One second. So PDF document we have opened. If you see, first task, you have to define common applications configuration for management and it is required and all. So don't get confused with these tasks and all. You don't need to worry about it. LDAP process, which we ran yesterday, same LDAP process. Define synchronization of users and roles from LDAP. Once we run, once we create a user account or reset password, so we have to run this process. That is conditional basis. Yes, if there is any changes in the security console that you have done for user accounts or roles, then you have to run this process. Is then that time, if it is conditional basis, that time it is required. Similarly, yes, run user roles and user and role synchronization process. Generally, we will run this process whenever, like, you know, just to synchronize both the applications in sync. Okay, like this, there will be different programs. Each task, one by one, it will tell you. Everything is not mandatory. Wherever it is conditional basis, wherever you require, that time only you can do. Define implementation users. This we have already done. Create implementation users. This also we have already done. Create data roles for implementation users. So this also we have done. So create data roles. Data roles. I think create data role we haven't completed, right? So after implementation project, I'll show you how to create a data role. Okay. And geographies, lookups, file-based import if there is any import. So like that, each and every task will be there. You can just go through it. What are all the different tasks that will be there in that? Okay. Once we could able, by the time we complete this session, you could able to understand each and every task, what has been given in the task and task list. Okay. Now let's go and create one implementation project. So let's create one implementation project. So to create an implementation project, you have to click on that button and click on plus symbol. Wherever you create in Fusion applications, you can see plus symbol. So to create, you have to click on. So here, give your own name. What is the project name? Uses HCM project. Next. Okay, next. So in this, what are all modules or what are all offerings that we are going to implement in our project? only those offerings we are going to select in our project. For example, if we are going to a client, and client would like to implement only core HR and payroll, okay, nothing else, then you don't need to select compensation management, because core HR and payroll only they would like to implement. In that case, directly you can go here and select workforce deployment. Select workforce deployment here, checkbox, just check this checkbox. Here also, payroll, absence management, predictions, time and labor, workforce profiles, network. This is BI analytics related to core HR. So whatever we need, we have added. If they would like to implement talent management, then you can add even workforce development as well. And if they would like to implement compensation, you can include this checkbox as well. So whatever offerings that you are going to implement, only those offerings you are going to include in your project. Save and open project. So you have created your project with the offerings, whatever you are going to implement. Okay, so workforce deployment. So this is what we have selected. So if you would like to do any implementation, any setup or something, you can come here and you can access it. All the tasks will be there. Define common application configurations. In this, you are going to synchronize users and security, implementation users, geographies, currencies, enterprise structures, all these things you are going to create over here. Each and everything you can come by order also. Once you create implementation users, you are going to create synchronization of users and all. And after that, you are going to create, again, if you would like to create any more implementation users, you can create. And geographies, you can create. Currencies, you can create. Enterprise structure, you can create. So once you create enterprise structures, then you can start loading data and all. So you can come even in order as well. So all the related things will be there in workforce deployment. So this is how. For example, if you want to assign any tasks to any user, you can select this. Click on assign tasks. So you can assign username over here. Okay. Directly you can assign the due date and you can assign the username so that the particular user is responsible to do that particular task. But in real time, we won't do that, because if you are working as a group, if not me, you also can do that particular task. Okay. Clear? Up to this, this is how you can create an implementation project. Once you get access, please create one implementation project and start it. Okay. Any doubts up to this?
No.
Okay. Done. Now, once this is done, let's see how to create a data security profile, manage data role and security profile. We have seen how to create a custom role, how to copy existing roles and all. Now we will see how to create a data role. For that, we have to go to setup and maintenance. From here also we can access. You have to search with manage data role and security profile. Manage data role and security profiles. Click on this particular task. So let's create one data role. So what is meant by data role? Data role is nothing but it is a job role. Only thing is we will provide certain restrictions, data restrictions on the job role. So we will take a job role. On top of it, we will provide conditions. For example, if I'm working for India, I'm a HR specialist. As a HR specialist, I can do everything, but only on India employees, not on other country employees, because it has been restricted like country basis. Such a kind of role is called the data role. Okay. So it's a job role plus certain conditions. Then it is going to be a data role. Let's create one data role. VSS.
HR specialist data role. So let's select job role over here. You know the importance of role, right? Just to assign some job with some restrictions, or else if you have to do a particular job to access corresponding functions, we will assign roles. Let's take this one. Next, another job role with the same name exists and is included in the data roles. Verify that you selected the correct job role. You may see two job roles with the same role name but different role codes. Okay, no problem. See, this is how the security criteria required. So we have taken the HR specialist role. So we have a human resource specialist role. Whatever functions or tasks that we could able to access with the HR specialist role, we will be able to access each and everything. On top of it, I'm providing here organization level security profile. Means which organization data only I could able to see. So I can define one legal entity level. So only that particular legal entity data only I could able to see. Or else only particular organization only I could be able to see. So all the organizations, whatever you have defined, will come here. So according to that, you can select. So here I'm going to select view all organizations. So instead, if I select a specific legal entity, only that particular legal entity data only I could be able to see. Okay. Similarly, position level. So which are all positions that I would like to see? I would like to see all positions or only specific position only it has given me access to see only this specific positions. So such scenarios, you can put the specific positions. But generally in real time, position specific role we won't give. Generally, if there is any organization, that only we will give. But all positions and country specific also we will give. For example, only one country data if you would like to see, only that particular country you will select. Otherwise, you can select all countries. There is a chart question, 1 second. Where you define organization, I will show you, Avinash. It's a initial setup. That's why if you understand this, that's well and good. Otherwise, keep it here, later you will understand automatically. Okay? It's just data roles. I have showed you all the roles except the data role. That is why I'm covering this here. Next, view all countries. So similarly, language security profile. You means legislative data groups. What is legislative data group and all will come once we start the enterprise and all. Actual setups we are going to start after this. Okay, these are all basics. This if you understand well and good, otherwise leave it. Okay, no issues at all. Like this, there will be different levels that provide security profile. So you can select whatever it is. If you don't understand this also, once you go to real time, if you couldn't able to see certain data or something, that time they will ask if there is any data role and all. That time you will come to know, okay, this is a data role that has been attached and all. You could able to easily able to come here and then research on it. Okay. Next. So with this task, we are done. We have provided all the restrictions on a particular role. Next, review and submit. We can see all the data here, whatever we have given, and then put a submit. Click on submit. So this particular role will get created. But I'm not going to submit here because it's a duplicate role. Next, so this is how you can create a data role. Now we will see how to create an enterprise. This is going to be an actual setups. So far whatever we have completed, whatever you need to do as a, you know, starting setups, if you are going for an implementation project, what are all things that you need is, first of all, you have to create implementation users. Generally, those tasks will be done by the project manager, because project manager only will get the access of FA admin user. By default, the user will come with the product. So by using that user only, project manager will create all the remaining other implementation users. So he will create some 4-5 users and he will give you those users to you with some roles and responsibilities. Next, once you took the roles, once you have those roles, then you can create your own users. Okay, you can create your own users, assign roles, whatever you need, or you can assign roles to those users and everything. Once this particular implementation users creation and passwords, resetting passwords and the role assignment is done, then you are going to be create implementation project. One implementation project you will create. Sometimes even project manager only will create implementation project. Project manager only will create implementation users. All these tasks will be done by him only. Okay. Sometimes you might need to create. Okay. But implement the creation of users and all, anytime you might need to create. Because in their implementation time also, sometimes you might need to create one user and then try to log in with him and try to assign roles to him. So those tasks can be done by you also. Initially, he might he can do it. Okay. So once users creation and implementation project is done, then the next task is you have to create a geographies. Okay. Geographies. Next one is geographies. Let's see geographies here. So for that also, you have to go to setup and maintenance. See, here one more area is administration. So whatever you are going to create implementation project, if you select here workforce development, workforce deployment, so corresponding administration area will open. Click on setups. Here if you click on setup, so all the tasks will come in order. So it will be easy for you to understand. First, initial users you have to create. Enterprise profile you have to create. Legal structures you have to create. Organization structures you have to create. And then users and security and data loaders. If you would like to load any data and all, you are going to use HCM data loader. So all these tasks will be in order. So corresponding initial users will come here. So if you want to create, you can create users here as well. Now let's create an enterprise profile. First of all, before going to enterprise profile, we have to create a geographies. Order, this is the order. Create implementation users and then create implementation project and come here and load geographies. So here, first to manage geographies, we have to create. We have to go to manage geographies, next step. Already in the document I have given, step one, create user account, step two, these, and then geographies. So it is in order only. You are going to create a geographies. If you are going for support project, you don't need to worry about all these things. All the things were already done. The only thing is you have to know where it will be and all. If at all any issue comes, you just need to go there and then look at the issue. Now let's see, for example, here the country code is US. So once country code is here in US, so nothing will be there. For example, let's say geocoding is not defined and structure is not defined and validations were not defined. All these things you can do it from here only. So first of all, let's see how to define a structure. So let's go here. For example, here we have state, county, city, postal code. And if you would like to add extra one more thing, let's say line one. So what you can do is you can create and add geography type. You can directly create one geography type and add it. So line number. Save and close. Corresponding line number will come. So even you can enter this also in the address field. So whenever you click on address, apart from state, county, city, postal code, line number also will appear. So if you would like to add any existing geography types, these are the existing geography types. You can add anything from here. Area, district, emirates, governance, local admin, province, anything you can add from here. Let's say town we are going to add. So town will come. So like that, even you can define the geography types and even you can define the structures as well. Okay. So when you take US, automatically the structure will appear like first you have to enter state, first you have to enter county and then city and then postal code and then line number and then town. So like that, you can define geography type and geography structures over here. So for that, where you have to come? You have to come to
manage geographies. Okay, manage geographies and search with country code. It will come here automatically, and then you can define the structure and then define the hierarchy. Let's define the hierarchy here. Generally, these geographies, see, let me tell you one thing. If you are going for US, UK, or something, whatever it is, loading all the countries and their corresponding states and their corresponding postal codes and all, it's not so easy task. So in real time, what they will do is they will get this list from the third party and they will load it into the system. That's what they will do. Okay. So there are some third parties who is going to provide, like, you know, up to date real time all restricted states and geography related data, and simply they are going to upload it into the system instead of creating manually all this. Next. So here, if you come here, so you can see for US, after states are coming. If you click on state, counties are coming. If you click on county, cities are coming. If you click on city, city is the last one that we have seen, right? Postal code. Yeah. Postal code is there. So still, if you would like to add any more postal codes over here, all the postal codes in Akutan will come here. So if you would like to add any more postal codes here, you can add it. If you'd like to, after county, if you'd like to add any structure, you can add the structure. Okay. So you got it. You can add in between any counties, any state, any city, like that. You can define the complete hierarchy. So let's add here. Under city, I'm going to add one more thing. I can give the name here. What is the primary code and code type, data provided, and who is the language? Who provided, user entered, or some, these are all some third parties. Okay. So is it user entered or is it some third party system through that we are going to load all this data? This also we can enter. So you can create in between the structure also. You can build the structure, you can create the geography type, you can add it in the hierarchy. So all these things we are going to do it in geographies, manage geographies. Next to validations. So validations means you might have seen while filling some applications, if you enter some wrong data, it will say it's invalid data, it's invalid data. So means if you are providing list of values as well as the validations, so that time if you try to enter the value which is not there in the list or else any wrong value, it will not take. It will validate it if you say it's a wrong value or else it's a invalid value. That we will provide here. So geography validation level for count country, is it available? No validation right now. But if you say error, validation will come and it will provide an error. Error details, it's an invalid data. So something like that it will provide if you give error. Otherwise right now it is not doing any validations. So like that, even you can provide the geography validations as well. So from interview perspective, you're not going to get any questions over here. And these are all basics that we have already done. I mean, people have already done the basic level itself. So and majorly, you are not going to create all these things. If you get it from third party, you will just load it into the system. For that, you will use load geographies. Once you load the geographies, you will come here and then see the structure, how the structure has been defined, how the validations have been defined and all. So here, load geographies, if it is for Mexico, you can use load geographies for Mexico, reference data set, or simply manage run geography loader. This also you can use it. Load geographies for India, load geographies for Canada. Like this, you can have so much of data. Okay, file import mappings you can create. File import objects you can create. So through file also you can create the geographies. So entirely you can create manually, you can load it by using different techniques also. Now let's create, after this any doubts? Anybody? So let's create.
Yeah, I have a question. Yeah, if there is no task available, can we create a new task here in the list of tasks, like manage geographies, run geography loader? Like if there is no task for any country which is not there, like load geographies for any country, mm-hmm. like Canada, or Canada is already there. I mean, like for any country which is not there, Austria.
Tell me one thing. Actually, if you are creating a customized task, if you are going to open a new page, no, right? Altogether, you are going to open the same page. And coming to your question, actually, they have provided some for India, for Canada, something like that. But apart from that, if you have a file format, even it is allowing to load a file format as well. So directly you can load it. Even if for Austria or some other country also, you can load it through file format. That also you can use it. So you don't need to have a specific task for Austria.
Okay.
You got your answer?
Yep.
Okay, great. Okay. Next.
So meaning like these are the predefined tasks given by Oracle, but for the other ones, like we can load it directly.
These are file imports, right? File imports, loaders, and all that stuff. You can use it directly. You can use Run Geography Loader.
Okay.
Here you can give the batch name files. Once you did the file mapping and all, here you can give the batch names and all.
Okay.
Now, let's see an important task, enterprise. So let me tell you one thing. Here enterprise is a root. It's an umbrella. Whatever you do the setups, all the things will come under one enterprise. So completely, if you're going to implement data, Tata is going to have only one enterprise in their complete system. When they buy the product, they can create only one enterprise. That is going to be a Tata. Okay. So whatever you do under that, you create legal entities, you create structures, you create organizations, you create jobs, whatever you do, it will come under enterprise only. So enterprise will act like an umbrella. So under that only, all the setups and all the configurations and all the organizations will come under that. Clear? So each and every client is going to be how many enterprises?
One at least.
Only one enterprise, okay?
Only one enterprise.
Okay. Only one enterprise. So now let's see how to create an enterprise. So for that you have to go to establish enterprise structure. So here to create an enterprise, where we have to do? We have to click on create plus symbol. Let's create an enterprise. So by default, whatever got loaded into the system, that will come here. By default, actually here it is KLS, but if you buy a product, it will not be KLS, it will be Vision Enterprise. Okay. So that time you are going to take out Vision and you are going to give your own name. And what is the short name? USS Enterprise. Primary industry. So what it specifies is, if you specify the primary industry, what is the primary industry for your organization, according to that you can build a solution. That is why it is asking. So let's say my primary industry is on finance and insurance. Then where is my headquarters located? Where is my enterprise headquarters located? Let's say it's in United States. What is the legal name for my enterprise? USS. What is the legal entity identifier? Let's say some details, some name will come here. Registration number, 12345. And legal reporting unit registration number. These details will be given by them only, okay? And legal address. So definitely one address should be there if you are going to create an enterprise, right? For example, if say, I say my organization is there. Definitely what the question, next question that you are going to ask? I'm running a business. So definitely what is the question that you will ask immediately?
Where your business located?
Exactly. So definitely you should have one location, one address should be there, legal address. So you have to create this legal address and then click on OK. This is going to be your legal address. Next, you have provided enough information to configure a simple enterprise with a single legal entity operating
in a single country. Select an option below. So with this, whatever the top information that we have given, it is asking you have provided enough information. So continue with the interview to set up more legal entities. Complete the setup. Whatever I have done, just I'm going to complete, or else I want to continue. In this case, I wanted to continue actually. Next. Okay, now we have created the enterprise name. Okay, after the enterprise, what is going to be there? After the enterprise, what is going to be there? Legal divisions. Okay. I'll show you the structure once again. How it will come. First, enterprise will come. And then after this, divisions will come. Okay, this is going to be divisions. Again, this is going to be after divisions, business units, legal entities. Legal entities will come. In that legal entity only, I'm going to define LDGs, legislative data groups, payroll statutory units, all that stuff. And after that, business units and reference data sets like that, it will keep going. Legal entities, after that business units, after that reference data sets and all.
Departments also, Praveena.
All those things you can come under organizations and all. Business units, departments, organizations, whatever it is.
Okay.
And here, general hierarchy. I'm just showing you about general hierarchy. Okay, this is how the structure will be. First an enterprise will come, and then divisions, and then legal entities, and then business units, and then reference data sets. After enterprise, divisions is not mandatory. If you, according to your business requirement, you can create divisions. But most of the people used to prefer having divisions if they have business in different countries. And even for reporting purpose also, divisions are more helpful. So those are the two reasons that people, that makes force people to have divisions in their organization hierarchy. Okay, so after enterprise, we will create divisions, legal entities, business units, reference data sets. Let me explain you how you are going to define your solution. Let's say you are going to implement for Tata. Tata is having business in only India. Is it there in India?
No.
Different multiple countries, right? So for each country, is it going to be the same rules?
No.
No, right? So those things you have to see first. First of all, once you go to the client, you have to understand the business. What kind of business they have, and which country they have those business, and what are all the rules, and what modules they were looking for. So legislation specific importance is there or not. So based on that, you have to define your solution. Let's say if they are looking for payroll, absence management, and all that stuff, then legislation plays a major role. So that time, for each country specific legislation rules, you have to apply to their business in that area. So first of all, you have to create divisions. How you will create divisions? If they have a business in different countries, US division, UK division, Asia division, something like that you will create. And then coming to US division, under that, in US also they can have business in different states, right?
Yeah.
So for different states, they can create legal entities. And even legal entity, one state also, they can have multiple businesses. Like what Tata Motors is one and Tata something, software is one. So both are two vertex, right? If both are going to be same legal entity, both are going to have same legal entity. Because legal entity, I will explain you what is a legal entity first of all. Legal entity is nothing but it's a tax reporting, it's a government registered entity. Okay, in the government records, we are going to define it as a legally this has been existed here. So all the things, whatever you are going to take it, like your tax and everything, you are going to pay from a legal entity. It's going to be legally registered in the government records. Okay, so that's what legal entity means. So if there are two different vertex, like Tata Motors and Tata Software, both are two different vertex, right? So in that case, both have the same legal entity generally. Will you support like that? Motors is completely different hardware business. Software is completely software business. Are you going to deal both in a single legal entity? Yes or no?
Yeah, we have a different legal entities for
these. Right? So even though in the same state also, if they have two different buckets, they can have two different legal entities also. Got it?
Right, yes.
So like that, you can define the solution. You have to understand the business and then define the solution. Like, okay, first of all, you have to, you can have any number of legal entities. There won't be any restriction. So under division, there will be legal entities. So like that, if you do, what will happen is, if a person who wanted, who is going to handle entire US business, if you wanted to see, a report of all the businesses that were existed in US, can get a report at the division level so that he will get all the reports at the division level, US division level, so that it will be easy for him to track all the business. So for that purpose, the general hierarchy what we will follow is enterprise, divisions, regulatories, business units, group entities. And for the freshers who couldn't be able to understand manual, don't worry, it's a pretty simple thing to follow this structure. Enterprise, divisions, regulatories, business units, group entities. Because you have to keep practicing it, then you will understand exactly what it is and where it is working in that. Because of precious functional concept, simple shot will not come. They have to keep practicing it, and actually more data they will get from the real-time job. Once they actually get to learn it. Okay? What you have to do is blindly follow the structure. Once first you have to create an enterprise, under enterprise then you have to create a division, under division you have to create legal entities. Under legal entities, you are going to have business units. Under BUs, you are going to have different variables. Okay? This is the standard flow even Oracle has given. See here, divisions, legal entities, business units, and reference data sets. Now, let's create divisions. Let's create divisions. What is the division name? USS division. What is the country? Similarly, what is the location? So I have created one division here. Click on next. So already the division which I have created, the enterprise which I have created, corresponding legal entity will come here. Because by default, when I create an enterprise, they will be given legal address, right? So automatically it will consider as an ultimate holding company. Once I create an enterprise, so automatically that particular thing has been considered as an ultimate holding company. Have you ever seen this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where we have given?
The first page of the, when we were establishing
enterprise. First, when we are creating enterprise, that time we have given, okay? So once you create an enterprise, automatically with that name, a legal entity will come that is going to be an ultimate holding company. Still, if you would like to create one more legal entities, you can create one legal entities. If you would like to generate automatically also, you can generate automatically. Click here. Okay.
So, so Praveena, this becomes like a parent legal entity of sub-legal entities.
Not sub-legal entities. It is going to be a parent, ultimate holding company. I told you, right? Once you create an enterprise, it's going to be an umbrella. Under that one, everything will come.
Yeah, so for enterprise, like this legal entity will be the topmost.
Right. This is
and below that, then we will have main, like maybe in US, Canada, or maybe in other countries and all that.
You can have whatever entities, you can create anything you can do.
Yeah.
Okay, so already enterprise we have created one, and division we have created one. I'm going to select this as a division. Okay, both the things, both the names I wanted to create as a legal entities. Means division also I want to define it as a legal entity, enterprise also I want to define it as a legal entity. So like that you can create divisions and even business units like that. But this you can do it by using enterprise configuration, structure configuration. If you have all the requirements handy, client has given all the requirements in the beginning itself, then you are going to do all these things. But generally it won't happen. Okay, it won't happen generally. They couldn't able to give all the requirements in a single shot. So you have to do all those things manually. Whatever you have created here, generate automatically. Instead, you have to create each and everything manually. You have to create legal entity manually, division manually. How and all, I will show you. Okay, let's, once you are done with this particular enterprise configuration, can we take it up tomorrow? It's already 7:52. Next batch will join. I'll complete union tomorrow, okay?
Yeah,
no, sure.
Thank you. So far, any doubts up to this?
Yeah, I have a doubt about the business unit, meaning like how come the business unit is under the legal entities? Can you just elaborate that part?
Sure. We will have a full-fledged elaboration once we go through one by one, okay?
Okay, all right.
Yeah, because today it's just a basic, I've given you an overview, but one by one we will go through it tomorrow.
Sure. All right.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Bye-bye. Have a nice day.
You too. Have a good one. Bye.